हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ बबल सॉर्ट, इट्स इंट्रोडक्शन, इट्स एल्गोरिदम, इट्स सॉल्ड एग्जांपल एंड द ड्राई रन ऑफ एल्गोरिदम। ऑल दीज थिंग्स आई एम गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज। बिफोर मूविंग टू द कंटेंट, आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स एंड कीप द बेल रिंगिंग। In this current video, I am explaining you how bubble sort works. How will the bubble sort work with the set of values? So let's start with first of all the introduction of bubble sort. The bubble sort is the simplest method of sorting algorithm. Basically, it is based on the technique of comparison, and the comparison is done between the adjacent elements, that is the every pair of the adjacent element. After the comparison, if there is a need to exchange or swap the elements if for any certain order, then the swapping or the exchange is to be done, and that's why this sorting technique is called as exchange sorting technique. So swapping is nothing but the main part of this algorithm, and swapping is to be done if the elements, adjacent elements, are not in said orders. So let's see what we have to compare. We have to compare the adjacent elements, and after comparison we have to take a decision whether to swap the elements or not. If they are not in the required order, then we have to take a decision of swapping or the exchanging. The swapping means the changing their positions. That is, let's see the example over here. Here are two elements or a pair, that elements we are going to compare. If you want these two numbers in ascending order, obviously you will say that 32 must appear before 52. So that's why we are exchanging both of them or swapping both of them by changing their position. 32 will take a position of 52 and 52 will take a position of 32, and now after swapping, here you can see that they are in a ascending order. We'll see the concept of iteration and passes. What are the iteration, what are the passes, because this is again the important concept with respect to any of the sorting technique. So with respect to bubble sort or any of the sorting technique, what are the iterations? So iterations are nothing but the swapping between the pairs while doing comparison if they are required. So if required, if needed, if it is necessary, whatever the swapping or exchanging of the position of the elements is to be done between the pair is nothing but the iteration. And combinedly, the number of iteration forms the passes. So what is pass? So iterative swapping, whenever required, whatever we have done for all the elements of the array, combinedly it forms the passes. So in total, the passes are nothing but the iterations or the set of iterations where we are going to compare the elements present in every pair, and the swapping is done if it is needed. This iteration process is done repeatedly for all the elements of the array, and at the end of the array we can say that we have done with the pass. So the set of iterations form the passes. Here I am explaining you the same thing, that is iteration and passes, with few more details. That is, swapping between pairs while comparison, if it is required, is nothing but the iteration, and the what it does, it rearranges the elements in the desired order. That is, it may be ascending order or it may be a descending order, and the set of iteration combinedly forms the passes. So what are the passes? Passes are nothing but the iterative swapping of all the elements of the array, and what it does, it helps us to form the array in a sorted order, that is in either ascending order or in descending order, and in case of a bubble sort specifically, the passes settles the large elements at end of the every pass and vice versa. That is, in descending order, it settles the smallest element at the end of every pass and the largest element at the beginning of every beginning of the array. So these are nothing but the passes. Now let's see how the sorting, bubble sort, actually works. And let's keep in mind that I am going to explain you all these things with respect to sorting of the elements in ascending order. So what will be my first step? So first step is, for all the pairs, if they are not in order, reorder them by swapping. That is, we have to compare the elements from every pair. If they are not in order, we have to order them by swapping. So this is called as iteration of the current pass. This is the iteration, and at the end of every iteration, the largest element is located at the end of every pair. We have seen the example of the number 52 and 32, where after swapping, 52, which is the largest element, is at the end of the pair. Now let's see the step number 2 is with respect to the passes. So we have to continue this step number 1. What is step 2 says? Continue step number 1 till end of the array, and this is called as the pass, and this will be the end of the pass. If you are at the end of the array, it is nothing but the end of the pass, and at the end of the every pass, the largest element is located at the end of the array. Here the largest element is located at the end of every pair, because this was the iteration, but this is a pass. Pass deals with all the elements of your array, and that's why if it is bubble sort, at the end of every pass, the largest element is located at the end of the array. And what will be the third step? The third step is, we have to continue the step number 1 and step number 2 n times if the size of array is n. We have to continue all these steps for n number of times if it is having n number of elements. So in total, n minus 1 number of total passes are required to sort the size of size n of array. And at the end, you can see that here at the end, a list will be in a sorted order, that will be in ascending order, because this is the steps, these are the algorithm for sorting of the elements in ascending order. So thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the video or the content, please do not forget to give the comment, as well as do not forget to share it with your friends. Here I am providing you a shortcut link for the subscription of my channel Tech Talks, along with this, a next video of this video series, and the whole series I am going to provide you in the form of playlist. So thank you. Happy data structuring, happy learning. Thank you.